Did you ever think about when whatever we eat and breathe, how every organ gets it? That is via our circulatory system. Circulatory system allows blood to transport or pass nutrients, gases, hormones, and different other nutrients to the body organs and from the body organs. Our circulatory system is also called as cardiovascular system or vascular system. In vertebrates, it is closed kind of circulatory system. It allows fluid to pass through network of vessels. There are two kinds of fluids. First one is blood and second one is lymph. So there are two types of circulation or systems, that is called as first one is cardiovascular system and the second one is lymphatic system. Circulatory system consists of heart, blood vessels that consist of arteries, veins, capillaries, blood and lymph. Our heart is mesodermally derived organ. It is situated near thoracic cavity between the lungs and towards little left side. It is enclosed in ribs. Heart is guarded or protected by a thick double walled bag like structure that is called pericardium that encloses pericardial fluid. Heart is divided in four chambers. Upper two relatively small chambers are called atrium or atria. Lower two larger chambers are called ventricle. Atria are separated by a septum that is called interatrial septum. Ventricles are also separated by a septum that is called interventricular septum. Atria and ventricle of the same side are also separated by a septum that is called atrioventricular septum. In atrioventricular septum, there is an opening or valve to connect atria and ventricle of the same side. This valve, right atria and right ventricle septum or valve is called as tricuspid valve because it has three muscular flaps. Left atria and left ventricle atrioventricular septum valve is called bicuspid valve. Our heart allows flow of the blood in one direction only. So these valves prevents backward flow of the blood. Right ventricle of the heart is connected with pulmonary artery. Left ventricle is connected with aorta. Left atrium is connected with pulmonary vein that carries the oxygenated blood. And right atria is connected with vena cava that carries deoxygenated blood from the body. The blood in our body flows in fixed direction through blood vessels. Blood vessels like arteries and veins have three layers. Arteries have much thicker wall than the veins, because arteries carries the oxygenated blood from the heart to our body organs. Heart pumps blood to the arteries. That's why arteries have to bear the pressure that is coming from the heart to pump the blood. That's why the thickness of wall of the arteries is much higher than the veins. There are three layers of the blood vessels. The innermost layer is the tunica intima, which is made up of squamous endothelium. The middle layer is called as tunica media, which is made up of smooth muscles. This tunica media is very much thin in veins. The outermost layer is tunica externa, which is made up of fibrous connective tissues with collagen fibers. The main function of our heart is to collect deoxygenated blood from all over the body parts or the organs. This deoxygenated blood goes to the lungs where it gets oxygenated. This oxygenated blood comes again to the heart. This is called as pulmonary circulation. This oxygenated blood pumps via heart to the body organs where they get nutrients and oxygen. Deoxygenated blood is collected via veins venules to the heart again. This is called as systemic circulation. So there are two kinds of circulation. This is also called as double circulation. Right ventricle of our heart is connected with pulmonary artery. This pulmonary artery pumps deoxygenated blood to lungs. In lungs, this deoxygenated blood converted into oxygenated blood. This oxygenated blood via pulmonary vein to left atrium. Via left atrium, it goes to left ventricle, and left ventricle is connected with aorta. Now, heart pumps this oxygenated blood via aorta to arteries and capillaries, and it goes to the blood body organs where they get nutrients and oxygen. Deoxygenated blood is collected via veins, venules and vena cava. Vena cava is connected with right atrium. So deoxygenated blood gets into right atrium, and through right atrium it goes into the right ventricle. So the cycle begins again. Blood consists of plasma, RBC, WBC and platelets. Plasma is the fluid where RBC, WBC and platelets are suspended. RBC is the red blood cells which carries iron molecules through which they get their red color. White blood cells are the fighting molecules, or they provide us immunity. Platelets are the molecules which are important for blood clotting. So this is all about very short video on circulatory system. Thank you.